Hello everybody, this is Theron. Welcome to the Minecraft Snapshot Tour. So we are still playing 15W42A. Today is the 18th, it's a Sunday, it's October 18th, and we're still playing last week's snapshot. I wanted to show you something that I played while playing around, so let's go. So I'm actually in kind of an interesting situation where I, let me take off this stuff. I'm actually really close to being caught up on videos, which is super odd for me. I'm normally behind by quite a bit. So I think that's kind of interesting. So I have, do I need Silk Touch for what I'm about to do? Yeah, just in case. We got some torches, we got that stuff. Yep, water's good. Ender pearls, compass, and that don't matter. Okay, in case you haven't figured out, we're going into the end. Oh, no, get out, get out. Before we do that, what time is it? I don't know, I'm not wearing my watch. It's getting late. Let's go to sleep. So normally I'm quite a bit behind. Like, I'll sit down and on a day that I record, I'll record what will essentially turn into 2 or 3 episodes. And then I go and I've spent a lot of time, you know, finding time to edit them and do all that good stuff. So, and then I'm finding time to upload them. So it takes a little while. And then, you know, those will end up getting spread out. The last couple of weeks, I've been getting good opportunity. There we go. Oh, you know what I should do? Strength potion. Okay, let's see if I got some over here. So I'm almost caught up. I have one episode that I recorded on Thursday that I've edited and will upload tomorrow, which is Monday the 20th. And then I'll have this that I recorded that I'll have to edit and upload. But in theory, I can get caught up by the time the next snapshot comes out on Wednesday. Presumably it's Wednesday. Oh yeah, here we go. These could come in handy, and so potentially could that. And so could these. So I'm gonna take these. I'm gonna take a couple of these. Let's bring some ladders. I know this is... All right. Here we go. So I expect the next snapshot will come out on Wednesday. Oh, sorry, excuse me. And it will probably be 43A, unless they have a problem and release a B or C snapshot. All right, so so that will be, I'll play that on Wednesday. I was unable to respawn the dragon. I think there's some problem. If you remember, the first time I came into the end here, the dragon had already sort of been marked in the world as if I had already fought the dragon. And that was due to the version of the game that I either created the world or initially generated the end in. I don't know which. But so basically, the dragon fight didn't happen right away. I had to go in and fix... I had to edit my world file in order to get the dragon to spawn. And so last time I tried to respawn the dragon with clay drawing a creeper face. I know it works in this version because I've done it on other worlds, but it does not work here. So that's kind of annoying. Oh shoot, you have to be super careful there, Theron. So I want more of these little gateways. There we go. And because I want to go out to other islands other than this one. That was redundant. I want to go to islands. Because if you remember, hi dude. Yeah. Ah, thank you. I wanted to replenish my ender pearls. That worked nicely. So I went, did I fill up my inventory? I did. We could do that. Okay. So I, pardon me. So I wandered all around this island and looked at the nearby islands, and I was unable to see any, end cities, I think is what they're called. And, so that was, frustrating. I wanted to go out to other islands to find them. But then I was wandering around, and I had my view distance turned up a bit. And look what I found right there. That looks to me like it's an end city. So we just need to get over there. I have no idea how far away that is. So I just brought a bunch of blocks, and we will, we'll just start bridging out. What could possibly go wrong? Okay, here we go. Goodness gracious me. Don't really need to do this out of stone bricks. I could use stone, I could use cobblestone, I could use lots of things, but I have plenty of stone, and I like the way the stone bricks look. Those look like they're up above from where I am, so we'll, and I don't know how safe I should try to make this, but we'll, I can always go back and get more, and this takes forever, which it might, because I'm going to be somewhat careful. Then I will cut away, and we will come back when I have more progress made. So if I go directly out to there, that should work. I think so. Awesome. Okay, so what else is going on? Everyone is publishing their... Everyone is publishing all their Minecraft story mode videos, and that's kind of interesting. It's like a choose your own adventure sort of interactive fiction type thing using the world of Minecraft as a setting. It kind of makes for boring videos, frankly, because everyone sits there and they watch the cutscenes, and really the games are one big long set of cutscenes with occasionally you get to choose, do you want to do this? Do you want to do that? Do you want to say this? Do you want to say that? So yeah, it's not the most entertaining. It doesn't make for the most entertaining videos in the world, but I don't know. Maybe I should play it. Doesn't seem super appealing to me, because they do just seem like very non-action versions of non-action versions of say Space Ace or Dragon's Lair, where you just kind of have to go through, and for the most part it seems like there's a right and wrong answer to most of the situations that are posed. So, not super appealing to me. Seems a little bit on the boring side. Perhaps I'm wrong. I don't know. Okay. Hey, dudes. Oh, you know what? I should turn down my view distance here, because if it generates any additional islands, that could cause effectively cause some lag, and I could fall off into the void. I did leave most of my good stuff behind, just in case that happened, and just in case one of these jerks. Okay, I think I need to go one more up. Just in case one of these jerks decides to teleport over and try and hurt me, I'm gonna have a difficult time dealing with a situation like that. And notice I'm not putting safety rails on this yet. I will, just not right now. That should be good, right? That'll get me to that island at least. Cool. So I got way behind on my YouTube videos, my YouTube subscriptions, and a lot of it was because of all the story mode videos. So I was able to go clear. I watched a few, and I was able to go clear the rest after I decided didn't make for the most entertaining videos in the world. So I was able to go clear out quite a few more. So I'm almost caught up on my YouTube videos, which is nice. Okay, I'm going to be super cautious here. Let's see what else. You probably notice, not hearing any air conditioning. It's still kind of warm outside, but it's muggy, and we got some rain here in the Los Angeles area. So, oops. So I have the... It's not super warm inside the house now, so I have the AC turned off, so I can record. I also want to record some audio for another project that I'm working on. Hey, dude. In the planning stages of a podcast, which I don't think I mentioned last time, but it's a podcast, nothing to do with Minecraft. Sort of about science and technology and sort of interesting, fascinating stories having to do with history, science, technology, medicine, just education, mathematics, you know, that kind of stuff. So I wish I had it up and running last week, because last week was Lady Ada Day. And Ada Lovelace, for whom it is named, is a very fascinating character. She was the first person, she gets called the first computer programmer, but really the, do I keep going out here or do I go, I heard you. Careful. Or do we go out an angle here? Let's go out an angle. Might make things... Wait. If I go out to that island, then I can stair step up. She was kind of a theoretical programmer. Wouldn't really call her a programmer the way you would think of a programmer today, primarily because she didn't have a computer to program. She worked with a man named Charles Babbage, who built complicated machines that initially were designed primarily to do complicated math, the sort of math that they would have people work for hours and hours and hours and weeks and months and days and years and on to come up with pages and pages of tables so that people could do calculations quickly. But it was essentially people doing long, complicated multiplication, and it was somewhat error-prone. And so Babbage was looking for a way to automate it. So he built machines that could add numbers together. And honestly, if you could make a machine add two numbers together, That machine can also multiply numbers together, and it can subtract numbers, and it can divide numbers. Because it's all really different variations on addition. I mean, I'm really simplifying things there, but it's basically the case. It's complicated addition. So he had this machine called the difference engine and another machine called the analytic engine. And he was trying to get them built. He built one of them and he was in the process of trying to raise funds to build the other. And Ada Lovelace found out about it. And she was a fascinating character. Son of Lord Byron, famous poet. Apparently not a particularly good husband or father. Surprise, surprise. And Ada Lovelace's mother was concerned that... Oh, hey, dude. Oh, am I going to run into that? I might. She was concerned... Oh, crap. Okay, hang on a second. Sorry for the language. I want to go make this guy despawn. I just looked at an Enderman on that other island. He's too far away to teleport towards me, but if he stays irritated, that could be a real problem. So I'm going to walk over here and make him go away. So, Lovelace's mother decided to raise her such that if she had any... inclinations towards the artistic, like her father, that she would essentially have all that trained out of her. Whether or not that could possibly work, or whether it did work, it's hard to say, but she found out about what Babbage was working on, and she proposed the notion that the analytic engine could, in theory, be used to do more than just mathematics. It could be used to do complicated... It could be reprogrammed. It could be instructed what to do dynamically. And so you could write, in theory, a program to instruct it, I want you to do these types of calculations, which is what a computer does. So she came up with the notion of a programmable... device, a computer, and she proposed some ideas for how it would work, and apparently Babbage didn't quite have the same degree of forward thinking or vision that she did, and didn't feel it as didn't feel that it had quite the same potential. So people now celebrate Ada Lovelace Day as a way of remembering Ada Lovelace in particular and women in general who have contributed to science and technology and computers and all that good stuff. And so that happened this past week. If you're interested in, if that sounds like an interesting topic to you, there are plenty of resources on the internet that you can look up to learn more about Ada Lovelace and her contributions to computers and all that good stuff. There was an early programming language called Ada, that was named after her. Let me pick those up. That could be usable. And let me, whoops. Oh, careful, careful, careful. Light that up. There we go. So I think there's probably a story there to be told about Ada Lovelace next year around that time. So probably put that on the calendar of things to talk about. We're probably one of the first shows that we do is probably going to be a discussion of the vocoder, which you've heard, even if you haven't heard of. It's a weird little piece sticking out there. It's a device the way it gets used most frequently in popular music is that it is used as a kind of an effect to make like a robotic sounding voice. And the funny thing is that our concept of what robots sound like, what robotic sounding is, come from the vocoder, because we didn't have talking robots in the 1930s when this thing was invented. So it gets used as that way as an effect, but it also gets used in another way that you've definitely heard. Even if you say you don't listen to modern music, popular music, the vocoder is essentially is the skeleton of what the auto-tune device is built on. Because the vocoder basically takes sound, breaks it up into frequency bands, and transmits the information about what frequency information is there. Once you have that, you can use it for compression, and most modern audio compression techniques do this. They break the audio up into subbands, and then they figure out which bands they can either reduce the amount of information or get rid of altogether based on how likely you are to hear it. Should we do that then? I think so. The original idea for the vocoder was to use it as a way of compressing voice data to go out over telegraph wires. In fact, get voice data on telegraph lines, which were not designed for it. But it got used in World War II as an encryption technique, as a way of transmitting voice information between two sites in a way that nobody could listen in on. And so that's kind of an interesting, it's a topic I find interesting. So I think vocoder will be the first episode. See, that looks like one of the ships, which is awesome, because that means that's where the wings, the elytra or lytra or whatever, however you pronounce it, that's where those are located. But it looks like it's not entirely rendered in. I did some tests on a creative world and determined that although each time you defeat the dragon, you get new little portals, the mini portals pop up, and you can have up to 20 of them, and they encircle the main island where the dragon fight happens. Initially, I thought that until you generated that and went through it, it didn't generate the outer end area. But that, I believe, is incorrect. I've done some testing on a creative world. That looks like there's something wrong there. This is going to be interesting. And you can fly out away from the island in creative mode, and it will generate the outer islands. I don't know if there's a accepted name for them yet. But you don't have to go through the portals. So once I get out here, I should be able to kind of island hop. And there's this ring that starts about 1,000 blocks out and goes all the way around 360 degrees. That really looks like there's something wrong there. That's going to be fascinating. And The end cities are relatively rare. Not every island has one, although I've seen islands that have two or three. And the ship, the little pirate ship, end ship or whatever it is somewhat rare in that it only appears next to some of the end cities. Yeah, see, I should be seeing one of the end cities next to this here, if it were to have generated the way all the others have. So this is going to be fascinating. May have a little bug here, and it could have something to do with the way the end was generated here. And I may have to make my little highways out around to other areas. And the reason why I'm doing this is because I can't get the dragon to regenerate. So I can't make those other little portals. And I've been doing some research. Maybe there's a fix I can come up with. I don't know. But since I can come out and do this, I may as well. Ooh, big island with nothing on it. Half a ship. Yeah, I'll keep going. Interesting. Oh, careful there, Theron. Goodness. So, anyway, so I've been working on that. Working on the logistics, doing the research on the vocoder episode. And also an episode on number stations. Number stations are shortwave radio stations which transmit voices, sometimes real but usually synthesized, which gets us back to the vocoder. Actually, voice synthesis came out of the vocoder. If you've ever played with a Speak and Spell, which is a toy from the 80s, late 70s, 1980s, that you may or may not be aware of. Oh, wow. Oh, okay. And these stations just broadcast numbers. It's a voice. Just say nothing but long strings of numbers and occasionally little phrases in between sets of numbers to sort of, they think, set apart where the little sequences begin and end. The assumption is that these are used by intelligence agencies around the world for transmitting information out to secret agents. But that's largely a guess. I don't want to say no, but we don't really have good confirmation that is the case, although it seems highly unlikely that it is not the case, just because of the nature of them and the fact that they were most active during the Cold War, and although they still exist, they are a little less active today than they were back in the 70s and 80s. So I also want to do a story on number stations. So busy doing research on that. So, yeah. Okay, let me build a little bit more here. Oops. See if I can get up here without getting myself smashed in the face by an Enderman. That is the weirdest thing. The podcast, if you're curious, is called Whisper Condition, which actually is a reference to a part of the vocoder story, and We will talk about it in probably the first episode, maybe second episode. We were looking for a name that was that I could get the domain, the URL for, and also was not already taken on iTunes. And we went through a few ideas and ended up on, I saw that the term whisper condition when I was doing my research on the vocoder story, and it's like, oh, that's it. I think that will do. Oh, that's just so bizarre. So, so you can go, I have a website up now called whispercondition.com, and we'll be posting, I'm going to record an intro, kind of a preview episode after I get done recording this. Another reason why I wanted things nice and quiet with the air conditioning off. Should I just pillar up from here? Oh, there's a chest. Oh! Now there's... Oh, that could be bad. Okay. So that guy there is called a shulker. Am I at the right level here? And that could be bad. Oh no, don't want to do that. Let's make a little platform up here though. And he shoots at you. And if he hits you, does damage. But more importantly, oh. Oh. Oh shoot. Okay, get over the road. Eat. Don't need to eat. Okay. Fascinating. I didn't even think about that. I had ender pearls in my pocket. I should have used them. So... that's why the elytra or the elytra is useful, because you can glide back. I don't know if I could have made it all the way back to the island there. Let's go get my stuff. I'm going to have to figure out a good strategy for dealing with these guys. But all my stuff should be, oh, a lot of the stuff should be on the walkway there. So we will see. Oh. What time is it? Can I sleep by any chance? Yes! At least I can respawn to here. Okay. Oh. So I'm going to record the little intro. A little preview. Won't be an episode per se. It'll just be me. I will be working with... hello, dude. A friend of mine that I know from Crash Space, and I will be... Oh, shoot. I have a problem. Okay. Hurry up. Go back. I need ender pearls. And I don't have a sword, so I can't kill any of these guys. Did I... Oh, okay. That's okay. I've got some at the base. So I'll be hosting the podcast with my friend Justin, who is I know from Crash Space, and he's a very smart guy and knows a lot of things about a lot of stuff. So he'll be the source of plenty of the stories, and so we'll go through and we'll host that. But I'm just going to record a quickie little preview, so that I can get something posted onto iTunes. So we can reserve the name. Oops, get out. know, where am I keeping the ender pearls these days? Here we go. Okay. So I'll be doing that, getting that uploaded, and then there'll be a feed. I'll generate an RSS feed, put that up on the Whisper Condition website, upload it to Apple for iTunes, and we'll be good to go. We'll be in business. Oh, I should have grabbed some food while I was there. I have plenty of food. Okay. Maybe we shouldn't be running the whole way. It'll take longer, but we don't need to starve to death before we get there. It's not like you can eat Enderman. You can eat chorus plants, though, or the chorus fruit, although it teleports you around a bit. Okay. Okay, I'm going to get my stuff and then we're going to end the episode. And I will figure out how to deal with these guys. I built these two out so I could put slabs in and be able to walk up quicker without having to do all the jumping and everything. Hopefully all my stuff is still there, including my food. It'd be nice to get my picks back too. Look at all those Endermen, that's crazy. One thing with these islands out here like this, it's going to make it a little bit difficult to, or it's going to make it more difficult to build an Enderman farm. Food. Okay, here we go. All right, let's eat. Figure out what went over the edge. So I still, I lost my bow. Blocks here still. Any sign of it? Okay, this might be super dumb, but I want my stuff. I've got endstone, water bucket. No, that doesn't help. Oh man. Okay. Well, we're gonna have to spend some time reacquiring hardware. All right. Well, I have ladders here, so I can come up here and back up to here. This should work. I'm going to go work on my situation here a bit and lament the loss of my bow. Oops, missed. Okay. And work out a strategy for dealing with the shulkers. That's a mob I've never had to deal with before. I lost a bunch of lanterns. Okay. Alright, well, thank you for watching. This hasn't been super exciting. I'll work on... I lost my silk touch pick. Dang it. Oh well. I knew there was a chance that something like that would happen. Don't want to get shot by that guy again. So I'm not sure. I'll have to work out strategies for dealing with those guys, because they're going to be in the end cities as well. All right. Well, thank you for watching. This is Theron, and this has been the Minecraft Snapshot Tour. All right. See you later. Bye.